Ms.M student. I am Mrs. Yamala, Ms.M professor, Department of History, Sri Sarada College, Salem. I am going to talk about Netaji Subhas Chandra Bose. What is the abbreviation for INA? It stands for Indian National Army. Who was the founder of Indian National Army? Indian National Army was founded by Netaji Subhas Chandra Bose. Subhas Chandra Bose, affectionately called as Netaji, was one of the most prominent leaders of Indian freedom struggle. Though Mahatma Gandhi and Jawaharlal Nehru have garnered much of the credit for successful culmination of Indian freedom struggle, the contribution of Subhas Chandra Bose is no less. He has been denied his rightful place in the annals of Indian history. He founded Indian National Army to overthrow British Empire from India and came to acquire legendary status among Indian Moors. Subhas Chandra Bose was born to an Australian family in Cuttack, Orissa. Subhas Chandra Bose was born on January 23, 1897. His father, Janakinath Bose, was a famous lawyer, and his mother, Prabha Devi, was a pious and religious lady. Subhas Chandra Bose was the ninth children among 14 siblings. Subhas Chandra Bose was a brilliant student right from the childhood. Janakinath Bose, Subhas Chandra Bose's father, was a prominent and wealthy lawyer in Cuttack who believed in orthodox nationalism and later became a member of the Bengal Legislative Council. He stopped the matriculation examination of Calcutta province and graduated with the first class in philosophy from the Scottish Church College in Calcutta. Bose was educated at Cambridge University. He was strongly influenced by Swami Vivekananda's teachings and was known for his patriotic zeal as a student. Indian Civil Service. His father wanted to Netaji to become a civil servant, and therefore he sent him to England to appear for Indian Civil Service examination. He was placed fourth with the highest mark in English. He resigned from the prestigious Indian Civil Service in 1921, but his urge for participating in the freedom movement was intense, that in April 1921, Bose resigned from the coveted Indian Civil Service, came back to India. Soon, he left home to become an active member of India's independent movement. He later joined the Indian National Congress and also elected as the president of the party. Bose was elected president of the Indian National Congress for two consecutive terms. After returning to India, Netaji Subhas Chandra Bose came under the influence of Mahatma Gandhi and joined the Indian National Congress. On Gandhiji's instructions, he started working under Desabandhu Sitaranjan Das, who he later acknowledged his political guru. Soon he showed his leadership and mettle and gained his way up in the Congress hierarchy. In 1928, the Motilal Nehru Committee appointed by the Congress declared in favor of dominion status, but Subhas Chandra Bose, along with Jawaharlal Nehru, opposed it, and both asserted that they would be satisfied with nothing short of complete independence for India. Subhas Chandra Bose also announced the formation of Independence League. Subhas Chandra Bose was jailed during civil disobedience movement in 1930. He was released in 1931 after Gandhi-Irwin Pact was signed. He protested against the Gandhi-Irwin Pact and opposed the suspension of civil disobedience movement, especially when Bhagat Singh and his associate were hanged. Subhas Chandra Bose was soon arrested again under the infamous Bengal Regulation. After a year, he was released on medical ground and was banished from India to Europe. He took steps to establish center in different European capitals with a view to promoting political cultural contact between India and Europe. Defying the ban on his entry to India, Subhas Chandra Bose returned to India and was again arrested and jailed for a year. After the general election of 9 shortly afterwards, he was elected president of the Haripura National Congress session 1938. During his term as a Congress president, he talked of planning in concrete terms and set a national planning committee in October that year. At the end of his first term, the presidential election to Tripura Congress session took place earlier 1939. Subhas Chandra Bose was re-elected, defeating Dr. Pattabhi Sitaramaiah, who had been backed by Mahatma Gandhi and the Congress Working Committee. Clouds of Second World War were on the horizon, and he brought a resolution to give the British 6 months to hand India over to the Indians, failing which there would be a revolt. There was a much opposition to his rigid stand, and he resigned from the post of president and formed a progressive group known as the Forward Bloc. At the outset of World War II, he fled from India and reached Germany. He sought an alliance with the Axis power with the aim of attacking the British in India from the northwest. At the outbreak of the war, Bose advocated a campaign of mass civil disobedience to protest against the Viceroy. Lord Langley Bose's decision to declare war on India's behalf without consulting the Congress leadership. Bose organized mass protest in Calcutta to protest against the wishes of the British government. He was thrown in jail by the Britishers, but was released following a 7 days hunger strike. Bose's house in Calcutta was kept under the surveillance by the CBI. Severe action was taken against him by the Britishers. He felt the British would not let him leave the country before the end of the war. It has been suggested that he was visited to see his wife, who was in Berlin. This set up scenes for Bose's great escape to Germany via Afghanistan and the Soviet Union. For this reason, he enlisted the help of Mayank Akbar Shah, then a Forward Bloc leader in Northwest Frontier Province. On 26 January 1941, Bose began his journey to reach Europe. From Moscow, he reached Rome, and from there he travelled to Germany, where he instituted the Special Bureau for India, Azad Hind Radio. He founded the Free Indian Legion out of Indian prisoners of war who had previously fought for the British in North Africa. At a time when no one in Germany dared to criticize Hitler, Bose was openly criticized of Hitler's treatment of Jews, the destruction of democratic institutions in Germany, and the Nazi invasion of Soviet Union. The lack of interest shown by Hitler in the cause of Indian independence eventually caused Bose to become disillusioned with the Hitler, and he decided to leave Nazi Germany in 1943. He travelled by the German submarine Imperial Japan, which helped him raise his army in Singapore. The Indian National Army INA was originally founded by the expatriate nationalist leader Ras Bihari Bose, who handed over control of the organization to Subhas Chandra Bose after his arrival in the Forest in 1943. The army was to be formed with Indians in the Southeast Asian countries and Indian soldiers of the British Army. Captured by the Japanese, Captain Mohan Singh was primarily responsible for raising the army. Ras Bihari Bose was made the president of the Council of Action. Shortly afterwards, Ras Bihari Bose dismissed Mohan Singh, whose personal ambitions endangered the INA. Ras Bihari then played a pivotal role in the organizing the movement. Subhas Chandra Bose was invited to take up the leadership. Subhas Chandra Bose became the president of the Indian National Army as well as the president of Indian Independence League, addressing a huge meeting at Singapore on 4th July 1943. Raj Bihari said, "In your presence today, I resign my office and appoint Desa Sevak Subhas Chandra Bose as the President of Indian Independence League." Gradually, the number of INA men began to grow greatly. Assuming the command of the INA, he held his famous battle cry, "Teli Chalo," He worked out a master plan of campaign for INA with the ultimate goal of reaching Delhi, a provisional government of Azad Hind. The Indian INA reveals Subhas Chandra Bose, their greatness as a military leader and organizer to one of the INA brigades advanced with the Japanese army up to the frontier of India. Indian national flag was hoisted in Kohima in March 1944, but with the change of fortune in the war and the retreated and defeated of the Japanese, the INA collapsed. The role of INA had far-reaching influence on the Indian political scenes. When the story of their remarkable courage and sacrifice came to the knowledge of the Indian people, at the end of the war, the nation came under the wave of revolutionary upsurge. The British government would realize that patriotism for Indians was greater than their service to the foreign power. Subhas was the greatest enemy of the Viceroy Lord Mabel. The communists described him as an agent of the fascist power. Gandhiji admired the courage and the resourcefulness displayed by Subhas in making his escape from India. In spite of his principles of violence, Subhas Chandra Bose's grand scheme of India's liberation and the high idealism through INA movement inspired the people of India in an unprecedented manner. The organization of Azad Hind Force and their exploits are milestone in the history of the Indian struggle for freedom, the formation of which was the brain child of Subhas Chandra Bose. INA trial, the midst of conflict between the Congress and the League, the government instituted a public trial of the Azad Hind Forge soldiers on charge of treason. The trial only helped to rouse the people patriotic emotion. Exploits of Indian led by Netaji strided the whole nation, and the country was thrilled with the excitement. The Congress engaged a set of lawyers including Jawaharlal Nehru, Tej Bahadur Sabru and Pulabhoy Desai to defend the leaders on trial. The INA leaders in the first instance were convicted, but their sentence were soon remitted and ultimately they were set free. However, some INA officers were not released, for which there was a public resentment. Demonstrations were organized in different parts of the country. Sarada's son Bose, the brother of Subhas Chandra Bose, mobilized the public sentiment in support of INA and made elaborate arrangement for the celebration of anniversary of the foundation of Azad Hind government on 21st October 1943. Bose's famous word, "Give me your blood and I shall give you your freedom," where he urged the people of India to join him in his fight against the British Raj, spoken at rally on India in Burma, July 1944. A close parallel would be Patrick Henry, "Give me liberty or give me death," spoken in Hindi. Bose's words and the highly evoked video and are considered an important milestone in the Indian freedom struggle. This was all he used to give the INA army to motivate them. "Jai Hind" or "Victory to India" was another famous quotation used by him and later adopted by Government of India. Conclude my topic. Bose was believed to have died in a plane crash over Taiwan while flying to Tokyo in August 1945. In May 1956, a four-man Indian team visited Japan to probe the circumstances of Bose's alleged death in crash of military aircraft at Taipei on August 18, 1945. There are theories of political effort classify information on the death mystery. The Mukherjee Commission submits its report to the Indian government on November 8, 2005. The report was tabled in Parliament May 17, 2006. The problem set it report that the Bose did not die in plane crash and the ashes at the Rangpoji temple are not his. However, the Indian government rejected the findings of commission. Thank you.